So only if you are following, then I will keep it updating. And let me tell you, ये जो प्लान है ये बहुत ही अच्छा प्लान है. इट इज वेरी वेरी गुड प्लान. ठीक है, ओके लिंगेश, नॉट एन इश्यू. आई विल शेयर एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन अबाउट द प्लान एंड आई विल गेट योर अपडेट्स ऑल्सो. ठीक है, सो आई विल रिकमेंड कि जो लोग भी प्लान फॉलो कर रहे हैं दे शुड इन्फॉर्म मी, दे शुड मैसेज मी. चलिए, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट टूडेज क्लास. टूडेज क्लास इज अबाउट द पेंडिंग टॉपिक्स ऑफ टैक्सेशन एंड आफ्टर दैट आई विल स्टार्ट external sector. We will discuss the issues from the external sector. Okay, so in the taxation chapter we have discussed various topics. In the last class we have discussed the topic still national anti-profiteering authority. Now in today's class we will discuss the rest of the topics. So the first question on your screen, please read the question carefully. I will give you the option to give the answer in the poll and then you can start giving the answers. Please don't give the answer in the chat box. Answer only in the poll box. Everyone, you have five seconds more. Please be fast. Give the answer. I can see all of you are giving the right answer. All of you are giving the right answer. I'm so happy. So you can see all most of you have given the correct answer. That is, the answer is option B. So the term base erosion and profit shifting, this term is associated with the tax evasion by the multinational companies. ठीक है, so what is the meaning of this term? Base erosion basically means, so what is the meaning of the word base? Base ka matlab kya hota hai? Base ka matlab hota hai tax base. So erosion of the tax base and shifting of the profit from high tax country to the low tax country, right? So when the income is being generated in high tax country, for example India, so in India we have the high rate of taxation. The rate of taxation is around 25% for the companies, and there are many other countries jisko hum bolte hain tax havens. Theek hai, so tax havens hain. For example, we have Mauritius, Bermuda. There are various other countries, right? So in these countries there is very very low rate of tax, or in many cases only 0% rate of tax, that is nil tax. So companies kya karti hain, they are generating the profit in India in high tax country and they are shifting the profit to the other country where the rate of tax is very very low. So this is called profit shifting. So what is the advantage to the companies? Company ko fayda hota hai, they are able to save the tax amount. ठीक है, तो इस तरह से वो tax amount को save कर पाते हैं. This is illegal, this is not illegal. और ये किस तरह से करते हैं, how do they do? इस तरह से करते हैं, let me tell you the mechanism. So please don't read the matter on the PPT, just understand the example which I am giving. For example, there is a company called Google. Google एक company है which is earning its profit in India. India में कोई business कर रहे हैं वो. In India they are doing some business. Suppose their sales value is 1000 rupees. Their sales value is 1000 rupees. They are selling the products of worth 1000 rupees. For producing these product, they are utilizing the services of some other some other company which is located in tax heaven. So they open one more company. Suppose Google Mauritius, and this is Google India, right? So this Google Mauritius will provide some product to Google India. Google India will buy some product from Google Mauritius. Okay. Suppose the real worth of this product is rupees 100. The real worth of 100 rupees. But to save the tax for shifting the profit, this Google India will say that we have purchased this product at rupees 800. Okay. So they will say that we have given the 800 rupees to Google Mauritius. So our profit is just 200 rupees. Right. If we see actually may the cost of this product is only 100 rupees. That means 1000 minus 100. That is 900 should be the profit. Right. 900 should be the profit. But Google India is saying our profit is only 200 rupees. So this 700 rupees is basically profit shifting. So profit shifting. So this profit has been shifted to the Mauritius. In India, the tax obligation on this profit would have been, suppose, at the rate of 25%. India made 25% hota, but in Mauritius, this will be only 2% or 5% or 0%. So huge amount of tax has been saved by the Google company by shifting the profit from India to the Google Mauritius. Okay. So this is called base erosion and profit shifting. So the base, the tax base of India has been eroded. India ka jo tax base hai, usko reduce kar diya gaya hai, usko damage kar diya gaya hai, aur jo profit hai, usko shift kar diya gaya hai India ke bahar. So this is the kind of practice which is being done in this case. So you can see the profits are shifted from high tax country to the low tax country. It is a tax avoidance strategy. Tax ko avoid karne ki strategy hai, which is used by the MNCs. So kon use karta hai isko? It is the MNCs, the multinational companies who are using this mechanism. Theek hai? There are various mechanisms. There are various tools which are used. Kya kya tools use hote hain? Transfer mispricing, inflating invoices. The example I have given, inflating invoices. I have given the example that Google India purchases the product of 100 rupees, but it pays 800 rupees. Theek hai? Theek hai? There are various methods. And why this happens? Aisa kyun hota hai? Because of some loopholes and some mismatch in the domestic tax laws. जो इंडिया का इनकम टैक्स एक्ट है उसमें कुछ ना कुछ लूपहोल है एंड दिस मॉरिशियस एंड इंडिया एट द कंट्री लेवल एट द गवर्नमेंट लेवल दे शुड हैव सम ट्रीटी दे शुड हैव सम एग्रीमेंट दैट इफ सच काइंड ऑफ प्रैक्टिस इज डन देन दे विल अवॉइड दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रैक्टिस बट दे कैन बी इनएडिक्वेसी इन द ट्रीटी प्रोविजन द मॉरिशियस मे नॉट बी इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस काइंड ऑफ एग्रीमेंट बिकॉज the countries like Mauritius, their main source of income is this kind of profit shifting only. They earn huge amount of money just because of this profit shifting from the high tax locations. So Mauritius kabhi nahi chahega ki unke yahan pe is tarah ka profit aana band ho jaye. Theek hai? Ineffectiveness of or lack of anti-abuse measures in the some tax jurisdiction. So we are not able to stop the tax as abuse measures. ठीक है हम उसको कंट्रोल नहीं कर पा रहे हैं ठीक है तो व्हाट इज बेस इरोजन एंड प्रॉफिट शिफ्टिंग शिफ्टिंग द प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम द हाई टैक्स ज्यूरिसडिक्शन टू द लो टैक्स ज्यूरिसडिक्शन इट अंडरमाइंस द फेयरनेस एंड इंटेग्रिटी ऑफ द टैक्स सिस्टम इट अंडरमाइंस द वॉलंटरी कंप्लायंस बाय द टैक्स पेयर्स तो जो लोग अपनी मर्जी से टैक्स पे कर रहे हैं कल को वो लोग भी बोलेंगे कि हम टैक्स क्यों पे कर रहे हैं जब बाकी लोग चोरी कर रहे हैं तो हम लोग क्यों टैक्स पे करें ठीक है ओईसीडी दैट इज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर इकोनॉमिक कोऑपरेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट ओईसीडी एंड G20 दे हैव डेवलप्ड द फ्रेमवर्क सो द कंट्रीज हु आर मेंबर ऑफ द ओईसीडी एंड द कंट्रीज हु आर मेंबर ऑफ द G20, they are working together, and over 125 countries and the jurisdictions, they are collaborating with each other, developing the practices which hampers the MNC from shifting the profit to the low tax locations. ठीक है, तो इस तरह का जो framework है ये OECD ने develop किया है और G20 ने develop किया है, and this is called BEPS package. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? BEPS package और BEPS project. It provides 15 actions and it provides various instruments. बहुत सारे तरह के instruments provide किए जाते हैं, बहुत सारे तरह के tools provide किए जाते हैं through which the countries can stop these kind of transactions. ठीक है, so the answer to this question is option B. Now, why this term was in news? ये news में क्यों था? This BEPS was in news because in India we are also reducing the corporate income tax rate. हम लोग corporate income tax rate कम कर रहे हैं, so that this kind of mechanism can be reduced, so that the practice of shifting the profit from India can be reduced. We have reduced the profit rate, the tax on the profit to 22% for the new companies. ठीक है, earlier it was 30%, then it was reduced to 25%, and now this is shifted to 22%. So we are reducing the tax rates for the corporate so that they are not motivated to shift the profit from out of India. If we see the major countries, Singapore, the corporate income tax rate is only 17%. In Thailand, this is just 20%. There are some high tax locations, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, even China. But you can see the profit is being shifted to these countries like Singapore from the other country. Okay? Now, next question, please see on the screen and then I will ask the question. I will open the poll box. Ramashish, let me tell your query answer. Then what is the profit of Google India, sir? They are sending the profit to the other country. So basically, it is a single company, MNC, Google. Okay? So they are shifting the profit from India to Mauritius, but overall it belongs to the same owners. The owner at the global level, they are the same person. So it does not matter whether they are having the amount in India or they are having the amount in Mauritius. It is just like they have two different bank accounts. They are shifting the amount from India's bank account to the Mauritius bank account so that they can save the profit. So for them, it is just like having the different bank accounts. Yes, they belong to the same group. They belong to the same group of companies. Chaliye. So, please give the answer, everyone. Everyone, please give the answer. Chaliye. So most of you have given the correct answer. The answer is option D, 1, 2, and 3 only. So all the three statements are correct, right? So this is a treaty. This is a treaty, multilateral convention treaty, and this is a result of G20 countries. This BEPS I have already discussed, and India was the part of this grouping. Okay, so all the three statements are correct. So this is a very factual question, but if you are not aware, you can take 30 seconds again and read the statements again. So in a way, this is a question which is providing you some additional information. Surajit, how are you? How is the situation in Kolkata? Hope everything is good. How is the cyclone, etc.? Chaliye. Next question on your screen. Please give the answer, everyone. Okay. Ramashish, aap bhi Kolkata se ho? Okay, Ramashish. Okay. Take care, Surajit. Everything will be good. चलिए एवरीवन प्लीज गिव द आंसर. चलिए वेरी गुड. आई कैन सी मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर गिविंग द करेक्ट आंसर. प्लीज सी योर स्क्रीन. आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी ओनली. राइट, आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी ओनली. कंट्री बाय कंट्री रिपोर्ट. राइट, सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज दिस? सो BEPS project of the OECD. Under this project, this OECD has given a framework where a particular kind of information is to be submitted by the MNCs who are working in more than one country. ठीक है, तो एमएनसी का तो मतलब ये होता है कि वो मोर देन वन कंट्री के लिए, मोर देन वन कंट्री में ऑपरेट करते हैं. सो दे विल गिव द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट इनकम एंड द इनकम टैक्स विच दे आर इनकरिंग इन डिफरेंट कंट्रीज. ठीक है, सो दिस विल अलाउ द गवर्नमेंट, द टैक्स अथॉरिटीज टू सी, टू इवेल्युएट द ओवरऑल पोजिशन ऑफ ए पार्टिकुलर कंपनी. दे विल बी एबल टू ट्रेस वेदर the profit is being shifted from India to other country, yes or not. So this country by country report is basically with respect to the BEPS project only. Yeah, so in India it is the Central Board of Direct Taxes, the highest authority for the income tax, which provides the rule for furnishing the country by country report, and this is required to be filled out by the multinational enterprises. OECD has developed this plan in the point number 13, where the MNCs, they will report their profit correctly where it is earned. Right, so wo batayenge ki unhone profit kahan pe earn kiya hai. Isko bolte hain country by country report. It will allow the assessment of the tax risk by the both administration. Okay, so answer is option C. Now next question on your screen. Everyone please give the answer. Okay, so poll box is launched. You can start giving the answer. So answer to this question is option C. As you can see, what is advance pricing agreement? Advance pricing agreement क्या होता है? So for example, there is new company which want to work in India. ठीक है? So let us take some example. For example, we take the example of Walmart. Walmart is a company which want to work in India, but it is not sure about the tax obligations in India, right? So it consults various tax consultants, tax experts, but still it finds that in the business model which is being followed by the Walmart, Walmart का जो business model है उसके लिए क्या tax obligation होगा वो clear नहीं है. They are not sure how much will be the tax obligation, right? Whether they will be paying the 10% rate of tax or 30% rate of tax. And because of this, they are not able to start their operation in India, right? So this tax obligation actually impacts the financial viability of the business. कि बिजनेस उनको इंडिया में करना चाहिए नहीं करना चाहिए, दे आर नॉट एबल टू डिसाइड बिकॉज दे आर नॉट क्लियर अबाउट द टैक्स ऑब्लिगेशन. सो इन दैट केस व्हाट दे विल डू, दे विल अप्रोच द इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट इन इंडिया एंड दे विल डिस्कस देयर बिजनेस मॉडल एंड इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट विल लुक इनटू दैट एंड इट विल टेल दैट हाउ मच विल बी द टैक्स ऑब्लिगेशन फॉर दैट काइंड ऑफ बिजनेस मॉडल, राइट? सो they take a assurance in writing from the income tax department. So income tax department will give the assurance in writing which is called advanced pricing agreement. ठीक है, जिसको हम बोलते हैं advanced pricing agreement. So advanced pricing agreement is a kind of written assurance which is given by the income tax department that in case you do the business in India, this will be the tax obligation which you are supposed to incur. So this will avoid any kind of future business uncertainty. This will avoid any kind of tax terrorism from the side of income tax department. And Walmart can evaluate the business model and whether it should be launched into India or not. So why this mechanism? So that in India we can invite maximum amount of foreign investment. ठीक है? तो इसका फायदा क्या होता है कि maximum amount of foreign investment हम ला सकते हैं. So this is called advanced pricing agreement, right? So it is ahead of the time, right? That means advance में हम लोग कर रहे हैं, business शुरू भी नहीं किया, फिर भी हम ये agreement कर रहे हैं. Agreement between the taxpayer and the tax authority. In this case, taxpayer is Walmart, tax authority is the Income Tax Department of India. On an appropriate transfer pricing methodology, ठीक है? So it is about the business model. At what price certain product or services will be कैलकुलेटेड, कि इनकम कैसे कैलकुलेट होगी, उस इनकम पे टैक्स कैसे कैलकुलेट होगा, ऑल दोस थिंग फॉर अ सेट ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शंस एट इशू ओवर अ फिक्स्ड पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो दे विल गिव दिस एग्रीमेंट फॉर 5 ईयर, 10 ईयर, ओवर अ फिक्स्ड पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ठीक है, दिस एग्रीमेंट कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप, ये दो तरह का हो सकता है. इट कैन बी यूनिलेटरल और इट कैन बी बाइलेटरल और इट कैन बी मल्टीलेटरल. ठीक है, सो इट कैन बी विद मोर देन वन टैक्स अथॉरिटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, दिस वॉलमार्ट इज working in India as well and it is also working in the USA. So there will be some transactions between USA and India. USA or India ke beech mein kuch transactions honge. So Walmart will take the right assurance in writing from both the USA income tax department and India's income tax department. Theek hai, to usko hum bolenge bilateral. Aur agar more than one country hoga, like more than two country hoga, to usko hum bolenge multilateral advance pricing agreement. So CBDT has entered into 26 EPAs in the first 5 months of this financial year. It brings certainty with respect to the tax outcome of the taxpayers' international transactions. जो international transactions होंगे उसके लिए certainty लेके आता है. It can be of two type. Either it can be unilateral, only with the one country, सिर्फ एक country के साथ में होगा ये, or it can be bilateral, multilateral with more than one country. ठीक है? So answer is option C, both 1 and 2. So this is about the chapter of taxation. Now let me start with the next chapter, that is the external sector. External sector ko hum log start karte hain. चलिए, सो इन द एक्सटर्नल सेक्टर वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द करंट अफेयर्स इश्यूज, FATF, Reciprocal Trade Agreement, FTA with ASEAN, MFN close, import duty, NIRVIC scheme, all those things we will discuss. Okay? So, the first question on your screen, please read the question carefully and give the answer in the poll box. So, in case you are reading the question, you have not completed reading the question, you can minimize this poll box and you can restart the poll box. So 5 seconds more. Everyone, please give the answer. Only 50% of you have given the answer. Are you enjoying the sessions? Are you benefiting from the sessions? If you need something else, please request me. I will try to provide from my side. Can you hear me clearly? Supriya is saying that I'm not audible clearly. Next class we will have on Saturday morning at around 10 a.m. Sorry, I have to delay today's class because of some unavoidable task which came up at the last moment. Chaliye. So the answer in this question is option C. Okay, answer is option C, but unfortunately most of you have given the wrong answer. Aap logon ne galat answer diya hai. Don't worry, not an issue. Answer is option C, FATF, Financial Action Task Force. It is the intergovernmental body. This is correct. This body meets 3 times a year. So this was a factual question tha. That is why Pakistan is on the grey list. Because of this, this was in the news. Iski wajah se news mein tha. Okay. Now next question. Everyone, please give the answer. Oh, sorry. Answer is given on the screen. Okay. 100% accuracy. yes. Sorry. Chaliye. India is a member of the FATF. So why this point was in news? Ye news mein kyun tha? Because Pakistan was placed on the grey list in June 2018. It did not control the anti-terror financing. ठीक है, it could not control anti-terror financing. So FATF is a intergovernmental body established in 1989 on the initiative of G7 nations. G7 nations were the most industrialized nations at that point of time. The head office, the secretariat is in the OECD headquarters of Paris. And what is the meaning of gray list? Gray list means in this list, those countries are included which are having the deficiency in the anti-money laundering or counter-terror financing regimes. So they could not control the money laundering or the terror financing. ठीक है, but they are committed. लेकिन उनकी इच्छा है, अंदर से इच्छा है उनकी. ठीक है, so they are committed that they will on one fine day they will be able to control. So Pakistan grey list में है क्योंकि वो बोलता है कि हमारी इच्छा है, हमारी इच्छा है. वो एक अलग बात है कि वो कर नहीं सकते, वो करना नहीं चाहते, बट दे विल ऑलवेज से कि हमें हम करना चाहते हैं. ठीक है, सो दे आर पुट इन द ग्रे लिस्ट. इफ वी सी देयर हैव बीन लॉट ऑफ कंट्रीज इन द ग्रे लिस्ट एंड दे हैव कम आउट ऑफ द ग्रे लिस्ट, दे एग्जिटेड फ्रॉम द ग्रे लिस्ट इन दीज मेनी इयर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इराक, इट टुक 4.67 ईयर्स एंड अदर कंट्रीज टुक अदर टाइम. द मिनिमम टाइम वॉज टेकन बाय द सर्बिया. ठीक है, answer is option C. Answer is option C, right? Next question on your screen. So this is a very, very easy question. Most of you have given the wrong answer. अभी आपको ऐसा नहीं करना चाहिए. You should revise. The question is very, very easy. Factual question है, but it's still very, very easy question. The answer is option D, that is Russia. ठीक है. So this agreement on reciprocal logistic support, this is about. This is a kind of defense agreement where both Russia and India, they will support each other's in the military operations. ठीक है, supplies, fuels, etc. So very, very easy question. There are different types of agreements between the countries. ठीक है, तो हम उसकी बात करते हैं. Let me tell you about those kind of agreement. So there are various a level of interrelations between the different countries. So you can see this screen. The first one is the preferential trade agreement. Please understand this very, very carefully. अच्छे से समझना है आपको, ठीक है? This topic is one of the very important topic, yet very misunderstood topic. ठीक है? हमेशा confusion रहता है कि FTA क्या होता है, monetary union क्या होता है, economic union क्या होता है. So please. Listen to this conversation very, very carefully. ठीक है, so one is PTA, preferential trade area or preferential trade agreement. What is this? So in this case, the two countries agree to reduce the tariff. Tariff का मतलब क्या होता है? What is the meaning of tariff? Tariff means the rate of tax on the import and export transaction. That is import duty, export duty. ठीक है, तो export duty और import duty को कम करने की बात करते हैं. For each other, for supporting each other, that is called preferential trade area or preferential trade agreement. ठीक है. The second is FTA, free trade area or free trade agreement. In this case, both tariff and non-tariff, both kind of barrier are reduced. दोनों तरह के barrier reduce करने की बात की जाती है. So tariff का मतलब होता है tax. ठीक है. और non-tariff किस तरह का होता है? Non-tariff is basically, for example, phytosanitary measures, that the food product should be of a particular standard. There should not be use of particular chemical. nowadays this corona covid crisis, in this case also some countries might impose some condition about the phytosanitary requirement. So this non-tariff condition are about phytosanitary, or it can be some quota that we can import maximum this limit of amount, maximum this quantity from a particular country. तो कोटा जिसकी हम बात करते हैं, अपर लिमिट इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्वांटिटी, वो भी हमारी नॉन टैरिफ के अंदर आती है. सो इन दिस केस, इन केस ऑफ एफटीए, बोथ टैरिफ एज वेल एज नॉन टैरिफ, बोथ काइंड ऑफ बैरियर्स दे आर रिड्यूस्ड बिटवीन द कंट्रीज हु आर इनटू एग्रीमेंट. ठीक है, द थर्ड लेवल इज सीयू, दैट इज द कस्टम यूनियन. ठीक है, तो कस्टम यूनियन जो है वो आपका थर्ड लेवल होता है. इन केस ऑफ नाउ बिफोर आई मूव अहेड, फॉर इन केस ऑफ पीटीए एंड एफटीए, suppose India and Sri Lanka, suppose India and Sri Lanka, they agree into PTA or FTA. So they have a certain agreement with each other, but for rest of the countries, so for example, India enters into some transaction with China or USA, or Sri Lanka enters into some transaction with Singapore or maybe UK. Okay? So the countries do not interfere in each other's policy. So Sri Lanka has nothing to say what will be the policy with the China, with the USA, and India has nothing to say what will be the policy with the with Singapore or UK. Okay, so their policies are independent for the other countries. Other countries se kya policy hai unko koi matlab nahi hai. They are concerned only about each other. Unko sirf apne bare mein pata hai, dusron se koi matlab nahi hai. But in case of custom union, they have the common policies. That means if India and Sri Lanka have entered into the custom union agreement, then all of the transaction which will be done with other countries, with the rest of the world, they will be having the common policy. That is the common tariff rate, common non-tariff barrier. ठीक है, so they have to have the common policies. The next level is common market or single market. ठीक है, common market or single market. So basically, before I tell you about the common market or single market, let me tell you this custom union, free trade area, and PTA. These three are for the goods only. These three are for the goods. The export and import of goods. ठीक है, they do not talk about any other matter. They do not talk about movement of labor, capital, or maybe investment. ठीक है, services. So they do not talk about services, investment, labor, etc. उनको कोई मतलब नहीं है. They are talking only about goods. But in case of common market or single market, they also talk about the capital and the labor. ठीक है, वो capital और labor के movement के बारे में भी बात करते हैं. ठीक है, then we have economic union and then we have monetary union. So this common market and single market, there is not much difference. In case of monetary union, they also have the common currency. ठीक है, इस केस में उनकी जो currency होती है वो भी common होती है. ठीक है, so for example, the euro countries, जिनकी common currency क्या है? Euro. So they are called monetary union. Okay, so this is all about the different level of integration between the different countries. So are you clear about it, everyone? Any doubt so far? Please say in the chat box if you have any doubt. So the first level is PTA, only for tariff. Second level is FTA, both for tariff and non-tariff. Third level is CU, where both the countries have common policy for the other countries. Then we have the CM or SM, common market, single market, where they are also including capital and labor. And then we have economic union, monetary union, where there is a common currency also. Okay, did you get this conversation? Did you understood this? Please say yes in the chat box. Keep interacting, don't sleep, don't be lazy. Please participate, don't be lazy. ठीक है, सो आई ट्राई टू कीप यू वेक अप इन द क्लास. आप लोग सो ना. ठीक है, इकोनॉमिक यूनियन. सो इन द इकोनॉमिक यूनियन, लाइक इट इज अ improved version of the common market or single market, where they have the common policies, common monetary policy, common fiscal policy, everything. ठीक है, for example European Union, जैसे कि European Union जो है वो common, जो European Union है वो आपका economic union है. ठीक है, monetary union is the next level of the economic union. In the monetary union they also have the common currency. So European Union is economic union, and inside the European Union, inside the European Union, there are certain countries which are having the common currency, that is euro. ठीक है, तो उसको हम बोलते हैं monetary union. चलिए, so in this case the answer was Russia. Now next question. Oh, in this case also the answer is visible. Really sorry, why is this happening? चलिए, आप लोगों ने आंसर देख तो लिया ही है, 100% करेक्ट आंसर. सो आरसीईपी, द पर्पस वाज टू अचीव mutually beneficial economic partnership among the ASEAN member states only. No, so this is between the ASEAN 10 ASEAN members plus 6 of their FTA partners. ठीक है, which include India also. तो 6 partner कौन कौन है उनके? China, Korea, Japan, Australia, New Zealand, right? But now India did not participate. India withdrew from the negotiation itself. So India is not a member of the RCEP. It has Australia, China, Japan, South Korea, New Zealand, plus 10 ASEAN members. ठीक है, India pulled out in the 8th RCEP. It was held in Bangkok, Thailand. Now next question, please read the question carefully. Everyone please give the answer. Still only 50% people have given the answer. Everyone please. चलिए, सो आंसर, व्हाट इज आंसर? द आंसर इन दिस केस इज ऑप्शन डी, नन ऑफ द अबव. ठीक है, वी विल डिस्कस दिस, डोंट वरी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, प्लीज रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुल्ली. So the answer in this question is option C, not any other option. But most of you have given the wrong answer. You can see most of you have given the option A, right? So India revoked MFN status in retaliation to the terror attack in Pulwama. ठीक है, पुलवामा में स्टॉप किया था. इट मींस इंडिया कैन लेवी एनी अमाउंट ऑफ इंपोर्ट टैरिफ. पाकिस्तान हैज ग्रांटेड एमएफएन स्टेटस टू इंडिया? नेवर, ये कभी भी ग्रांट नहीं हुआ. सो आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी ओनली. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एमएफएन? एमएफएन का मतलब क्या होता है? तो बेसिकली फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर आर टू कंट्रीज, इंडिया एंड चाइना, बोथ आर मेंबर ऑफ द डब्ल्यूटीओ. So this MFN status is applicable for the WTO members. So if both are member of the WTO, and then there are other countries like USA, we have Pakistan, we have suppose Singapore. ठीक है, तो क्या होता है? Suppose India is charging the import duty of 10% on any product from all the countries. ठीक है, सभी कंट्रीज से 10% चार्ज कर रही है. Now India decides to reduce this import duty. It wants to give the advantage to suppose USA. Suppose it says that for USA this import duty is 8%. If this advantage is offered to USA, the same advantage will be offered to all the other country members of the WTO, including China, Pakistan, Singapore. ठीक है, including China, Pakistan, Singapore. ठीक है, so this is called most favored nation status. ठीक है, तो ये आपका होता है most favored nation status. Okay, sorry. So there was some problem. Yeah, so this is called most favored nation status. And as per the WTO norms, all the WTO members are obliged to give the MFN status to all the other countries. So automatically, MFN status provide karna hota hai. ठीक है? But there are some exceptions. कुछ exceptions हैं जहां पर MFN status को हम stop कर सकते हैं. There are some exceptions. These exceptions include number one, in case of regional economic integration. ठीक है? So we discussed the idea of suppose this FTA, PTA, this custom union, economic union. So if there is this kind of agreement between some countries which are actually supporting each other, in that case this most favored nation status is not applicable. ठीक है? So if some advantage is being given to FTA partner, the same advantage need not be provided to the non-FTA partners, even if the most favored nation status has been given to the non-FTA partner. ठीक है? So for example, in case of ASEAN, NAFTA, or in case of India, even SAFTA, South Asian Free Trade Agreement. The second is, for some developing countries, for some particular market, if the access is to be provided to them, it is like not mandatory that same level of access is to be provided to other countries. For example, Kenya, if India allows some special concession to Kenya because it is a very poor country, in that case the same condition need not be given, the same benefit need not be given to the other countries. Third, those countries which are trading unfairly, theek hai, jahan par trade unfairly ho raha hai, for example there is dumping, kuch dumping ho rahi hai, theek hai, there is dumping or some other kind of activity, then also it is not provided. Or the fourth reason can be security exception clause, theek hai, national security, for example in case of Pakistan. So in case of Pakistan, we have withdrawn this MFN status after the Pulwama attack because of the security exception clause. Security exception clause ki wajah se humne ye withdraw kar liya, theek hai. So MFN status was given to Pakistan 1996. Pakistan never gave. Pakistan ne kabhi nahi diya. Hum logo ne badi bhai hone ke nate, being the big brother, we gave to the Pakistan, but Pakistan never gave. In February 19, India withdrew because of the Pulwama terror attack. And now India can hike the custom duty on exported goods by 200%. And this is under the security exception clause. Okay. So answer of the first question is neither one nor two, right? So it is applicable both to the goods and services. Aisa kuch nahi hai ki only goods ke liye applicable hai. And exception ke liye ek aur bhi provision ho sakta hai, that in case of services there can be some kind of discrimination in the special circumstances. Okay. Now next question on your screen. Please take 30 seconds. I will stop the poll in 30 seconds. Now I want that you increase the speed. Aap log apni speed badhao, theek hai? Now I want to take you to the examination level. Exam level ki hum baat karenge, theek hai? So everyone, I want the answer from everyone. If you are not participating, please don't come to the class. I am very clear. If you are not participating, please don't attend the class. If you are participating, then you should attend the class, otherwise not. Theek hai? Everyone please fast. And next time onwards I will give you only 30 seconds because I want more coverage. I want that your thinking speed is increased. चलिए, so most of you have given the right answer, but it's still only 43%. Answer is Malaysia. ठीक है, वैसे भी अगर आपको पता होगा, इंडोनेशिया एंड मलेशिया, दे आर द टू बिग कंट्रीज विच आर प्रोड्यूसिंग द पाल्म ऑयल. ठीक है, सो आंसर इज मलेशिया. सो बिकॉज इंडिया विथड्रॉ द स्पेशल स्टेटस टू द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, आफ्टर दैट मलेशिया प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ही गेव सम criticism to the India's पॉलिसी अबाउट द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर स्टेटस, ठीक है, एंड अबाउट द CAA. सो इंडिया बेसिकली इंक्रीज्ड, इंडिया इंक्रीज द रेट ऑफ टैक्स एंड इंडिया शिफ्टेड दिस ऑयल फ्रॉम द फ्री टू द रेस्ट्रिक्टेड लिस्ट ऑफ इम्पोर्ट. सो इट कैनॉट बी इम्पोर्टेड फ्रीली, द इम्पोर्ट विल बी रेस्ट्रिक्टेड. ठीक है, इंडोनेशिया एंड मलेशिया दे टूगेदर प्रोड्यूस 85% ऑफ द वर्ल्ड पाम ऑयल. ठीक है, 100% FDI is allowed in the palm oil plantation in India because this is the cheapest edible oil. This can be stable at the high temperatures. This is the main ingredient in the vanaspati, hydrogenated vegetable oil. So this is very, very important oil. So there can be a question about this particular topic. Okay. So answer is Pakistan. Malaysia. Okay. So this product has been moved from free to the restricted category. Next question on your screen. This question is very, very important because in the budget, union budget, this scheme was highlighted. Yeh scheme highlight hui thi, theek hai? So I will give you only 30 seconds. Everyone, please give the answer. Test yourself. This is the test for yourself, not for me. ठीक है, आई वॉन्ट ईच वन ऑफ यू टू पार्टिसिपेट. ओनली 5 seconds आर लेफ्ट. आई एम हैप्पी दैट ऑल ऑफ यू आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग. वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. चलिए, लेट मी स्टॉप. So in the 30 seconds, 14 people give the answer and most of you have given the correct answer. Very good. Wonderful. So answer is option A only. Chaliye. It is also known as, ECIS scheme, the Nirvik scheme, Export Credit Insurance Scheme. So what is Export Credit Insurance Scheme? Export credit means the loan given to the exporter. ठीक है, exporter को loan देते हैं. ठीक है, so this loan can be given for various purposes, for working capital or for other facilities like production. ठीक है, so this loan which is given to the exporter, on this loan the insurance is given under the scheme of Nirvik. तो Nirvik scheme के अंदर इस loan का insurance किया जाता है. In case exporter is not able to refund, is exporter is not able to repay the amount, in that case the insurance is available. This insurance is available up to 90% of the principal and interest amount. So if 1 lakh rupees loan is given to the exporter and there is 10,000 rupees of interest, so total obligation is 110,000. Out of 110,000, 90% amount can be recovered from the insurance company. Okay, so 99,000 can be recovered. So this is the risk coverage given to the loan provider. Yeah, so Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India, which agency is providing this insurance facility? The name of agency is Export Credit Guarantee Corporation of India. There can be a question, which agency is providing? It is the ECGIC. I am highlighting the same point again and again because those points which are think are very important for the examination. I highlight multiple times so that आपके दिमाग में, आपके कानों में वो गूंजता रहे, exam hall में आपको मेरे शब्द याद आए, मेरी वो commitment है. ठीक है, so it is announced to ease the lending process and enhance the loan availability for the exporter. When the financial institution, they will have the insurance, they can easily give the loan to the exporter. ठीक है, वो आसानी से loan दे सकते हैं. The loan which is available for the exporter will be very, very easy. It covers 90% of the principal and interest payment. It covers both kind of credit, that is a foreign as well as rupee. So the loan can be given in the foreign currency or in the rupee currency. Both kind of loan are covered, and in this case the loan is provided at in case of foreign loan below 4%, in case of rupee loan below 8%. The loan is available, the insurance cover is available for pre-shipment and post-shipment credit. ठीक है, तो माल सप्लाई करने से पहले के लिए लोन होता है, दैट इज द प्रोडक्शन एंड पोस्ट शिपमेंट, दैट इज फॉर फॉर रिसीविंग द पेमेंट, राइट? सो फॉर एग्जांपल एक्सपोर्टर इज प्रोड्यूसिंग द लैपटॉप्स, सो फॉर द प्रोडक्शन सम लोन इज टेकन बाय द एक्सपोर्टर, दैट इज कॉल्ड प्री शिपमेंट क्रेडिट. उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, प्री शिपमेंट क्रेडिट, कि एक्सपोर्ट की शिपमेंट करने से पहले, एक्सपोर्ट की सप्लाई करने से पहले जो लोन लिया गया. द सेकेंड लोन इज पोस्ट शिपमेंट, सो वंस द शिपमेंट हैज बीन सेंट टू द फॉरिन कंट्री, द अमाउंट इज ड्यू फ्रॉम द फॉरिन कस्टमर. सपोज द अमाउंट इज अमाउंट विल बिकम अवेलेबल आफ्टर 6 मंथ. सपोज 6 महीने बाद ये पैसा फॉरिन कंट्री से आएगा, द 6 मंथ पेमेंट पीरियड लिमिट इज देयर, 6 मंथ के अंदर पेमेंट आएगा. सो ड्यूरिंग दिस 6 मंथ दिस एक्सपोर्टर विल गेट द लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक, एंड आफ्टर 6 मंथ वंस द अमाउंट इज रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द कस्टमर फ्रॉम द फॉरेन कंट्री, राइट, देन द अमाउंट विल बी रीपेड टू द बैंक. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड पोस्ट शिपमेंट क्रेडिट. इसको हम बोलते हैं पोस्ट शिपमेंट क्रेडिट. द बैंक विल पे टू द प्रीमियम टू द ECGC. तो बैंक अपना इंश्योरेंस करवाएंगे, जो भी बैंक चाहता है इसका एडवांटेज लेना, they can give the premium and they can cover their loan. So this is very, very important because this scheme was highlighted in the Union Budget 2021. So budget जो February 2020 में आया था, उसके अंदर आप देख सकते हो, this image is taken from the budget. This scheme was highlighted. That is why this scheme becomes very, very important for the examination also. ठीक है? So it will, you know, there will be reduction of the premium for the small exporter. Simplified procedure, high insurance coverage, all these things are being provided in the revised scheme. Next is electronic certificate of origin. Okay, so certificate of origin kya hota hai? What is certificate of origin? So if suppose some Indian businessman, Indian exporter is exporting some goods to some country, for example China, and India and China have agreed to some special terms and condition. Maybe PTA, FTA. So China will require the certificate of origin from the Indian exporter to reduce the import duty. So jo bhi unka FTA ka agreement hai, us FTA agreement ko fulfill karne ke liye, to reduce the import duty as per the FTA agreement, the China will require certificate of origin from the Indian government, which has been issued by the Indian government. Theek hai? Now, this certificate of origin, earlier it was issued in the physical copy. पहले फिजिकल कॉपी में होता था, नाउ इट विल बी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक. ठीक है, इट विल बी पेपरलेस. अर्लियर इट वाज लाइक द कस्टमर हैज टू विजिट द ऑफिस. ठीक है, सो कॉमन डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ ओरिजिन. देर आर वेरियस एजेंसीज हु कैन प्रोवाइड, DGFT, MPEDA, टेक्सटाइल कमेटी, टोबैको बोर्ड. सो फॉर डिफरेंट सेक्टर डिफरेंट एजेंसीज आर देयर. ठीक है, so this is very important for the prelims examination. This is used for FTA PTA partners. Theek hai, India has 15 FTA and PTA where the Indian exporters, they avail the reduced import duty in the destination country. Now next question on your screen, please give the answer. You have 30 seconds, only 30 seconds. Let me see how many people are able to respond. Only 30 seconds. 15 seconds left. 10 seconds left. 5 seconds left. 2 seconds. 1. Oh. Okay. Let me give the extension of 10 seconds. 5 seconds left. 3, 2, 1, 0. So 40 seconds, only 13 people out of 18 could give the answer. Very, very good. I can see now participation is increasing, speed is also increasing. Answer to this question is option B, Ministry of Finance. ठीक है? So what is this scheme? ICE Desh, Indian Custom Ease of Doing Business Dashboard. So this is for providing ease of doing business for the in the customs department, so that during the export and import, export or import ke time pe jo procedure hai wo aasan ho sake. उसी तरह से अतिथि है, दिस इज अ मोबाइल ऐप विच इज डेवलप्ड बाय द कस्टम डिपार्टमेंट फॉर इंटरनेशनल ट्रेवलर्स टू फाइल द कस्टम डिक्लेरेशन इन एडवांस. इट इज यूज्ड प्राइमरली एट द एयरपोर्ट. ये कहां पे होता है? एयरपोर्ट पे यूज होता है. ठीक है, कस्टम डिपार्टमेंट इज बेसिकली कमिंग अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस. कस्टम डिपार्टमेंट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस के अंदर में आता है. दैट इज व्हाई वी कॉल दिस दीज आर द स्कीम्स ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस, आईएसडीएस एंड अतिथि. ठीक है, तो आईएसडीएस इज ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस डैशबोर्ड फॉर द यू नो ऑफ द इंडियन कस्टम्स विच हेल्प्स easy daily custom clearance atithi for the airports. Like iske liye mobile app hai airport travelers ke liye. Next question on your screen. So this question will require some time. I am giving you 40 seconds. Aapke liye 40 seconds start hote hain now. Let me see how many people give the answer. 40 seconds. Use 20 seconds for reading carefully, 10 seconds for rethinking, and last second 10 seconds for marking the answer in the poll box. ठीक है, ट्वेंटी seconds left, 15 seconds left, 10 seconds left. Everyone please mark. 5 seconds left, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Only 11 people can give the answer. I want fast answers. Anyways, not an issue. Most of you have given the wrong answer. Anyways, not an issue. Okay, let us understand. So in this case, the answer is all of the above. Option D. Okay. Are you enjoying this time limit? Are you enjoying this time limit? You can give the answer in the chat box. Are you enjoying this time limit of 30 second, 40 second? Is it challenging? Should I continue this? Okay, good. ठीक है, this is also increasing the speed और आपको इससे नींद भी नहीं आएगी. ठीक है, आपको इससे नींद भी नहीं आएगी सो क्लास के दौरान. ठीक है, so should we have the MCQ sessions for the other subjects also? रैंडम एमसीक्यू एमसीक्यूज ज्योग्राफी के लिए, पॉलिटी के लिए. आई विल गिव यू द टाइम लिमिट एंड देन आंसर. क्वेश्चन टाइम लिमिट आंसर, क्वेश्चन टाइम लिमिट आंसर. डू यू वॉन्ट दैट? बट आई नीड एटलीस्ट 50 पीपल इन द सेशन, सो यू हैव टू इन्वाइट योर फ्रेंड्स. आई वॉन्ट दैट मोर नंबर ऑफ पीपल पार्टिसिपेट. राइट, पीपल आर कमिंग एंड दे आर गोइंग. I don't see commitment. आप लोगों में से भी जो लोग अभी अवेलेबल हैं, I see there are some people who join and go back next day, like they are coming daily, but they are not there for full time. ठीक है, so I need 50 participants at least, then I can devote more time from my schedule. ठीक है, so invite your friends. If I see more number of participant, I will bring more initiatives. Chaliye, it is free of cost. You will, I will try to give 2000 MCQs in that fashion. ठीक है, 2000 MCQs के लिए कितना time चाहिएगा? We need 2000 minutes because one question we will complete in 1 minute. ठीक है, so 2000 questions. Okay, let us consider that every question will need 1.5 minute, 3000 minute. Divided by 60 minute, how many hours? 50 hours. Okay, so during the last month of the exam we can devote 2 hours on a daily basis. 2 ghante daily spend kar sakte hain aur abhi hum log jaise hum kar rahe hain waise chal sakte hain. So in the last 30 days we can devote 2 hours on a daily basis for solving the mocks maximum number of question. Okay, so daily ke daily hum log 100 MCQ solve karenge in the last 30 days, but I need 50 participants. So you have to invite your friends. You have to spread the message. I will put the message in the Telegram group. Spread the message. Let more people, more number of people join. Okay? I want commitment from your side also. Okay? So in this case, the answer is option D. So India has restricted export of common medicines such as paracetamol and other 25 pharmaceutical ingredients because of this COVID situation. ठीक है? What is the meaning of API? API means active pharmaceutical ingredient. They are the active ingredient which are part of the medicine. So there are two components. One is API, which is a central ingredient. Another is excipient, excipient, which is non-active. ठीक है? जिसका काम क्या होता है? The purpose is that to help deliver the medication inside your body. ठीक है? So they are chemically inactive substance such as lactose or mineral oil in the pill. ठीक है? तो lactose या mineral oil की form में हो सकता है. So the core is central ingredient, that is the API. ठीक है? So now we have stopped these three APIs. Next question on your screen. You have 30 seconds. Take 25 seconds for thinking. ठीक है? Don't be in hurry. 25 seconds are more than enough. So you have taken 55 seconds. Anyways, not much number of people are participating. I think they are thinking the question is difficult. In 1 minute, only 11 people can give the answer. Chaliye. So in this case, the answer is option B, because this HSN code is 6-digit code. This is a 6-digit code developed by the WCO only, World Customs Organization. So HSN, harmonized system of numbering, 6-digit identification code by the World Customs Organization. It is a kind of universal economic language. जिससे क्या बोलती है? ID मिल जाती है. Every product gets the ID, unique ID मिल जाती है. So that helps in the taxation, that helps in the identification of the goods for reducing the tax rate, right? Deciding the custom duty, deciding the rule of origin, deciding the monitoring of controlled goods, for example waste, narcotic, chemical weapon, ozone layer. So based upon the ID, these goods can be tracked, right? Wildlife trade, endangered species, ozone layer substances, right? So isse hamara jo kaam hai wo bahut aasan ho jata hai. The role of controlling authorities increases, it becomes more effective. Unka jo role hai wo kafi effective ho jata hai. Why this is in news? Because India will not allow imports without HSN code. This will enable India's exports to be accepted globally due to the quality of goods and services. ठीक है? So answer is option B only. Now, next question. You have 30 seconds. आपके पास में 30 seconds हैं. ठीक है? Sorry, again the answer is given. Really very sorry. Anyways, I have to be careful. Chaliye. So answer is option B, economic intelligence unit. Theek hai? ग्लोबल माइक्रोस्कोप ऑन फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन रिपोर्ट. ठीक है, तो व्हाट इज ईआईयू? दिस इज अ रिसर्च एंड एनालिसिस डिवीजन ऑफ द इकोनॉमिस्ट ग्रुप. इकोनॉमिस्ट ग्रुप जो है आपने नाम सुना होगा द इकोनॉमिस्ट, दिस इज अ न्यूज़पेपर. सो इसी का एक डिवीजन है, रिसर्च एंड एनालिसिस डिवीजन, ईआईयू. ठीक है, इट हैज ऑफिस इन द यूके लंदन. अकॉर्डिंग टू द इकोनॉमिस्ट इंटेलिजेंस यूनिट 2019 रिपोर्ट, इंडिया इज रैंक्ड एट फिफ्थ पोजीशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन. इट यूजेस फाइव डोमेन्स, द गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी, स्टेबिलिटी एंड इंटेग्रिटी, प्रोडक्ट आउटलेट, कंज्यूमर प्रोडक्शन एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. ठीक है,